Hi guys, today we're going to stop the food wastage challenge. We're going to see how much food I can waste in a week.
This morning I had some eggs and toast for breakfast. This is the first day and first meal of the challenge. As you can see, the food's come along quite a bit from before. And we're going to see how much the food weighs. So it comes out to about 960 g's.
We believe that food wastage can be utilised to produce valuable forms of biogas, which in turn can be used to power appliances and as such provide a viable and sustainable solution. In order to achieve this, foods with the most methane potential must be used. Generally, foods with a high lipid concentration and easily degradable carbohydrates have the largest methane potential, with foods such as fruits having the least. This process is broken into four different stages. Firstly, there's hydrolysis, where insoluble organic polymers are broken down. Following this, acetogenic bacteria converts amino acids and sugars into carbon dioxide, hydrogen, ammonia, and organic acids. Methanogens then convert these into methane and carbon dioxide, which can then be used to power all our appliances. With food wastage developing into an impossible challenge, it's time to make it a friend, not a foe. Okay, so while this alone will go a long way to resolve the energy crisis, we're not quite done yet. Chemical fertilizers leached from the soil into streams or rivers can drastically increase the risks of developing cancer in adults and children and severely affect fetal brain development. This is not news to scientists. The study relating to this was published in 1994. Chemical fertilizers are extremely harmful to both the soil and humans. But in order to meet the immense demands each plant needs, they're used anyway. So here's what we propose. See, as a compost agent, food waste is entirely unique. As being the primary source of organic matter, it boasts an abundance of nutrients, elements, meaning anything from fruits, vegetables, to dairy products, breads, meats, would all be composted with high potential. And what's more is the process itself of converting food wastage into an organic fertilizer. It's relatively easy and cost effective, with just 19 cents needed to make an entire batch of 100 kilograms. During the process, dehydration is the most important part. But once this is over, the dry nutrients only need to be broken down with simple enzymes to leave behind their constituent nutrients, both organic and safe to use on cropland and garden soils right away.
So in all, we've seen Krish discuss the damaging effects of food wastage, its future impact on our society, and yet its immense potential as an energy source. We've also seen another monumental social issue, the ongoing food crisis, and how food wastage can efficiently become a clean, environmentally friendly fertilizer to resolve this issue. And whilst all of these ideas are capable of incredible change, we wanted to go one step further. Our idea is an urban modern solution offering versatility, affordability, and high efficiency. This is Rushmore, a glass-based vertical farming solution using scalable energy systems based entirely on food wastage, powering hundreds of layers whilst using 90% less water than traditional farms. Each one of those will contain thousands of crops grown organically without the need of soil. Utilizing modern hydroponic technology and enriched by fertilizer produced entirely from the food we throw away, this is capable of producing yields 70 times that of traditional farms. With the population booming to 9.8 billion and 70% of those based in urban areas, we're running out of space and we're running out of time. This is the solution we need. This is what clean, locally sourced energy from the food we waste can achieve.
Produce electricity and energy in form of biogas is such an important thing, especially if you can turn waste into energy. That's a very economic means to be able to lift people out of energy poverty.